Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print these three patterns with the help of C program. So I will be implementing these with the help of nested loop. Before starting, I want to share one information. If you go to details or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists. Those are related to various topics in programming. So you can watch them to learn programming. Now I am going to start writing code to print this pattern first. So this is the first loop that I have written here. It's initializing through 1 and its termination condition is I less than equals to 5. So it will repeat 5 times, because here you can see we have 5 rows. If you want to print more rows, then instead of writing 5 here, you can read a variable from user above a for loop, beginning of the for loop, and then you can use that variable here so that a required number of lines will be printed to print these kind of patterns, right? So this for loop, which is repeating 5 times, will point rows. So here we have 5 rows, so 5 times it will repeat. Now if it repeat first time, so one alphabet should print. If it repeats second time, then two alphabets should print. So to print those alphabets, I am writing one more loop, which is starting from 1 and it will repeat till I. So this is the basic format of two loops. Those will be required to print these kind of patterns. So this is left align pattern. So here you can see we don't require to print blank spaces here. So here you can see when this loop will start from 1. So the second loop is dependent upon I. So if value of I is 1, so it will repeat 1 time. If value of I will be 2, so this loop will repeat 2 times, and so on. So this way this pattern will be printed. Now we need to identify how we can print these alphabets. So for that, I am going to declare a variable ch. So here you can see its data type is char, because we are going to print alphabets that are in form of character. So character variable is required here. And at the beginning, I am initializing it with capital A. So to initialize characters, we need single quotes. And inside single quotes, I have written capital A. Now inside this loop, using %c, I am going to print the value of ch, right? And after completion of this loop, I am going to increase value of ch by 1, and then printf backslash n. So this is the complete solution for this pattern. Now I am going to explain it line by line so that you can understand how this is going to be printed. So initially I will start from here. So I is 1, and at the top you saw we initialized ch with a. So initial value of ch is a. Now check the condition of I. It is true, then control will be transferred here. So j will begin from 1, I is 1, so this loop will repeat 1 time. So ch will be printed in form of character, so a will be printed. So this a is printed through this. Now this loop is terminated. We come here ch plus plus. So whenever we increase any character variable, so it is incremented by 1. So the increment operation will be done in the ASCII value of that character. So we have capital A, so its ASCII value is 65. So that will become 66. And its corresponding character is capital B. So in short, we can say whenever we increase any character, so the character increases its ASCII value. So here character was A, so it will become B automatically. Then printf will print new line, so cursor will come to second line, so that we can print B 2 times. Now I will become 2. So this time this loop will repeat 2 times, starting from 1. And I is 2, so it will repeat 2 times, and 2 times this ch will print same value, and current value of ch is b, so this b will be printed 2 times, right? So this is printed. Now after termination of this loop, again CH will be incremented. So this time it is C, new line. So control will be transferred to here. Now I plus plus will take place. So I will be 3. Now again if we move to here, so it is starting from 1 and it will go to 3. So 3 times it will repeat and CH will print C 3 times. So these 3 C will be printed. So this way this pattern will print the above format. And we are using CH++ here so that we can have a different alphabet in different rows, right? Now I'm going to convert this code for this pattern. So if we identify the difference, here you can see in each row we have similar alphabets, but here in each row we have different alphabets, but each row is starting from A and then it is incremented up to, like if row number is 3, so A will become B and then C, so 3 alphabets will be printed. If we are on row number 5, so 5 alphabets will be printed. So it is sure that before printing the alphabets, CH variable's value should be A. So I have declared this variable A. Now I am going to initialize it here as well. And here I am just declaring it. So before starting J, before starting J loop, CH will be always A, right? And when this loop will be repeating, so you can say we don't need to print same character or an alphabet in one row. So this CH will be shifted inside this loop. So I can remove this and I am writing CH plus plus here inside this J loop. And after completion of this, this printer will be printed a new line and now this program is complete. So this piece of code will print the second pattern. Now I am going to demonstrate you how it will be done. So I is 1, condition is true, then CH will be initialized with A. Now we will come here, so it will repeat one time, so it will print A to CH and after printing CH will become B. So this is first rotation of J which printed value of CH and incremented its value by 1. After termination, printf will print new line, so control will be transferred to second line. Now I plus plus will take place, so I will become 2. Now here you can see CH is again initialized with A. So CH is having A as initial value. Then this time is, this loop will repeat 2 times. So first CH will print A. Then CH plus plus will be now having value B. So current value of CH is B. Now again this loop will repeat. So CH will print B and CH plus plus. So value of CH will become C. So if we are repeating it 2 times, so 2 alphabets are printed and last value of CH is C. Now this loop is terminated. We are on new line. So cursor will be on new line. Then I plus plus. Now here you can see CH is again initialized with A. So now I hope you understood why I return a CH equals to A here. Because after completion of J loop, CH will be other than A. But for new line, we need to start CH from A. So that's why before starting J loop, it is initialized with A. So this time, this loop will repeat 3 times. So 3 different alphabets will be printed. And after completion of this loop, value of CH will be D. Then again, we will increase value of I. So CH will be initialized by A again. So this way, the second pattern will be printed. Now, see this one. So this is the third pattern. Here you can see we are going to print alphabets in increasing order. So no alphabet will repeat. All will be printed. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and so on. So it means we don't require this now. Here. We don't require this step here. We just need to initialize CH at the beginning. We need to initialize CH at the beginning. Then you can remove this from here. And here inside loop, you need to print CH and it will be continuously incrementing. So this is the solution for this pattern. So I hope now you can iterate this one so that you can understand how this pattern will be printed. So I hope you understood how these three patterns will be printed with the help of NestedLoop. I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and there you will find various playlists related to various programming languages. So do watch them, and thank you for watching this video.